गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक वन क्लास विच वन द कोर्स रिन्यूअल एनर्जी एंड ग्रीन टेक्नोलॉजी कोर्स हैव बीन ऑफर्ड फॉर योर फोर्थ सेमेस्टर कोर्स एंड इन दिस कोर्स दीज आर द कंटेंट्स. सो बेसिकली दिस कोर्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री पार्ट, बायोमास एनर्जी, सोलर एनर्जी एंड विंड पावर एनर्जी. सो I have given here the content is classification of energy sources, contribution of these sources in agricultural sector, familiarization with biomass utilization for biofuel production and their application, familiarization with types of biogas plants and gasifiers, biogas, bioalcohol, biodiesel, bio oil production and their utilization as bioenergy resources, introduction of wind energy and their application. So these topics will be covered by Dr. Uttam Kumar in subsequent classes. My part will include introduction of solar energy, collection and their application, then familiarization with solar energy gadgets such as solar cooker, solar water heater, application of solar energy that includes solar drying, solar pond, solar distillation, solar photovoltaic system and their application. So whole topics will be covered by two teachers, one myself Dr. Muhammad Irfan Ahmad Ansari, and second biomass energy will be covered by Dr. Uttam Kumar in subsequent classes. So see, in India, there is huge potential of renewable energy. So you can see from this picture that this picture shows the estimated potential of renewable energy power in India. So solar, the potential of solar energy power is 68%, wind power energy is 28%, and in other 4% it includes a small hydro power, biomass power, and waste to energy 6%. So from this figure it is clear that solar energy has immense potential for converting solar energy into electricity and for other purposes also. Wind power has 28% potential for conversion of wind energy, extraction of wind energy from wind to electricity. So many solar plants are installed around the globe, and also many wind power stations are installed around the globe. In India also it is has immense potential. So based on the geographical distribution of the estimated potential of renewable energy power, as on 31 March 2018, Rajasthan has the highest share of harnessing solar energy, renewable energy. That is about 15%, followed by Gujarat with 11%. And followed by Maharashtra 10%. So you can see that this renewable energy has immense potential for harnessing, and many states are leading in this area. So at present Rajasthan has the highest share of harnessing solar energy. So again, see this picture, this pie chart shows the state wise estimated potential of renewable power in India. So from this pie chart it is clear that Rajasthan has the highest share in harnessing renewable energy. And then see, next one is Gujarat 11%, and followed by Maharashtra 10%. So most of the state are already using solar energy, biomass energy and wind power energy, and after harnessing they are using for different agricultural operation and other purposes also. So this table shows that the state-wise distribution of renewable energy extraction capacity and share. So see, from the this table, Gujarat has the solar energy power generation is 35,770 megawatt. In Jharkhand, it has potential to harness 118,180 megawatt. And Rajasthan has the highest share. So from this table, data is 1,22,310 megawatt power generation facility is Rajasthan is having. So from this table, it is clear that Relwa Energy is the highest big potential of harnessing solar energy and other source of energy. So now come to things. I will focus on solar energy. So see the solar energy. So solar energy we receive from the solar radiation. So suns give both heat and light, and that heat is utilized, solar radiation is utilized for various purposes. So from the sun we receive the heat through electromagnetic wave. So sun radiation is the one of the mode of heat transfer through which heat comes to the earth surface by electromagnetic waves. So electromagnetic radiation from the sun heats the earth, and that radiation we have to, that energy we have to harness with the help of suitable technique and principles. So see, solar energy is the energy of future, and among all these renewable energy sources like biomass, wind power, solar energy has the immense potential, huge potential of harnessing solar energy. This is, so that's why solar energy is the energy of future, and it is practically inexhaustible, and it is easily available throughout the world. In India it is also easily available. So there are around 300 clear sunny days in a year in most of part of the country. Most part of the India receive good solar radiation, around 4 to 7 kilowatt per square meter per day. So this is sufficient for harnessing solar energy and developing different type of equipment. The average solar radiation incident over India is about 5.5 kilowatt per meter square per day over a horizontal surface. So Rajasthan receives maximum solar radiation intensity in India. In Rajasthan, the solar radiation intensity is around 6 to 7 kilowatt per square meter per day. Gujarat receives second largest amount of solar radiation. So first one is Rajasthan and second one is Gujarat. So from this data it is clear that Rajasthan has the huge potential of harnessing solar energy based on the solar radiation intensity available in Rajasthan. So Gujarat receives 5.5 to 6 kilowatt hour per meter square per day with 300 sunny days per year. So the amount of solar energy coming to earth surface is around 32.8 million megawatt every second. So see how much sun provides us the solar energy on the earth surface. This is a huge, big amount of the solar energy. So Gujarat is a leader in solar power generation in the country at present, and the state of Gujarat has commissioned Asia's largest solar park at Charanka village for power generation of around 1100 megawatt. So this is Gujarat's leading state at present. So in our state, the solar radiation intensity is 4.5 to 5.5 kilowatt per meter square per day. So again, this solar radiation is sufficient to harness the potential of solar energy. And based on this ability of solar radiation, many projects are running in the Jharkhand also for power generation. Annual average value of solar irradiation in Jharkhand is 4.78 kilowatt per meter square per day. And the nodal agency working in the renewable energy powered development and policy making is JEREDA, Jharkhand Renewable Energy Development Agency. This is a nodal agency and working in different sector of energy, so renewable energies like solar energy, wind power energy, then biomass energy. So this picture, this is a solar map. This gives idea about which state is receiving how much solar radiation intensity. Like Rajasthan is receiving maximum solar intensity, followed by Gujarat, Maharashtra, and we have seen the Jharkhand is also receiving good amount of solar radiation. So based on this data, one can develop, one can design different type of equipment for harnessing solar energy. Then solar energy conversion. The principle is that how solar energy can be converted in useful form. So there are two principles. One is conversion of solar energy into heat energy, and another one is conversion of solar energy into electricity. So conversion of solar energy in electricity is direct method, and conversion of solar energy into heat energy is indirect method. With certain technique, we can trap solar radiation, convert into heat energy. So we will focus these two principles in detail in subsequent classes. So covering this topic, solar radiation or solar energy or wind power energy, or you can say biomass energy, you have to refer certain books to enrich your knowledge, to increase your knowledge in these subjects. So first one, very important book is Solar Energy Principle and Thermal Collection and Storage by S.P. Sukhatme. So this one is very important book for your this course, and you must read this book. Second one is Solar Energy Fundamentals and Application. This book is also equally good for solar energy. So you can opt if this book one is easily available. Apart from these two books, one important book is Non-Conventional Energy Sources by G.D. Rai. This one is also very important book. So one book by G.D. Rai, another one by Sukhatme. This book you can refer for your study. Fourth one is Fundamentals of Renewable Energy Resources and Technology by Engineer Sanjay Kumar. If you like, you can choose this book also. And for examination point of view, you can read this book, Objective Type Question Bank in Renewable Energy Sources. This is very good book for your examination point of view. Then you can get lot of material from internet. One important site, I have given the URL address and home page, is e-course developed by IASRI. So the URL address is ecourses.iasri.res.in, and you must be knowing about this site also. So this site has many courses like agricultural engineering, horticulture, home science, veterinary science, and agriculture also. So first you have to open the home page, then you have to click on BSc Agriculture. After clicking, you will get the list of courses offered in BSc Agriculture. So these are the name of courses. So you have to opt Renewable Energy. So here, see Renewable Energy. Here you have to click View. After clicking on View, you will get the course content topic wise. So see, this is the course content, like Classification of Energy, Introduction to Renewable Energy, then characteristic of biomass, biomass conversion, biomass, biogas generation, gasifier, bio-oil production, biodiesel production. Most of the topics are covered in this, under this course. Biodiesel production, then solar energy, everything you will get from these materials. These are just simply notes, PDF notes. Then apart from these books, you can opt some journals for your enrichment of your knowledge. So one important journal related to renewable energy is Solar Energy. So any type of research article, popular article or review article, you can even publish. If you have any idea in your mind, you can publish that content in this journal, Solar Energy. And you can access through this website. Any latest development in solar energy you can find in this journal. So if you are interested, you can refer this journal. This journal is very important for solar energy. Many review articles you will find in this journal. Similarly, One journal is applied solar energy. This journal is also equally good. If you like, you can read this journal also. Many research articles are published every month. You can get from this site. Then another one is Renewable Energy and International Journal. Third one is this journal is also very good. You can go through from these articles. So this publishes every type of energy article, like maybe biomass, related to biomass energy, or wind power energy, or solar energy, and other related field. Then fourth one is International Journal of Renewable Energy Technology. So this journal is also very good. You can find lots of literature from this journal. Then some of the important ministry institute which are working in this field for promotion, for development of new technology. So I have cited some of the important institute, organization and ministries. So first one is Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission. So this, the main objective is of this mission is to promote solar energy power project, conversion of solar energy into electricity. Then one important ministry is, you know, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. This one is the nodal agency for India. Very important ministry. This ministry takes care of development, policy making, development of different sources of renewable energy. This is a nodal agency. Then IREDA. This one is also promoting and providing loan to the to viable project for conversion of solar energy into electricity for power generation. So see, this is the profile of IREDA. So this organization is again promoting solar energy, biomass energy and wind power energy. So this organization provides the loan. The main objective is to give financial support to a specific project and a scheme for generating electricity or energy through new and renewable sources and conserving energy through energy efficiency gadgets. So this is the working area of IREDA. Second one is Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency. So many agencies are right now working for promoting different type of renewable energy sources. So this agency is also working in different area like solar energy, wind energy, biomass energy, bioenergy, hydro energy. Then so this ministry, the renewable energy Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, from this ministry there is one, they publishes one very important magazine. The name of the magazine is Achcha Urja. Achcha Urja is available in both Hindi and English language, and this one is very important magazine for renewable energy. So you can find any type of literature related to energy sources in this Achcha Urja. So you can download, it is available freely from ministry website, and any latest development going in India you can find in Achcha Urja magazine. This is very important magazine. Then there are certain institute who are working in this field for promoting, for providing degree, diploma, training program. So one is National Institute of Solar Energy. So this institute provides training, provides diplomas, conducts some certificate course, diploma course and some BTEC program. Then another one is, one institute is National Institute of Solar Energy. This is under the, this institute is under direct control of Ministry of Renewable Energy. And this institute also provides some courses like BTEC program, diploma, certificate program, even PhD program also. Then one important organization is Solar Energy Corporation of India. This corporation is also working for promoting solar energy. Then another institute is Sardar Swarn Singh National Institute of Renewable Energy. This institute also organizes conferences, seminars, workshops, and provides some degree courses like diploma, certificate, provides training to farmers and entrepreneurs, and provides and conducting also some higher degree program like MTech program in energy and PhD program. So if anyone is interested, they can refer these sites for higher study. Then one research development organization is very important organization is Sardar Patel Renewable Energy Research Institute. This institute also working in energy. And then TERI, Tata Energy Research Institute. This organization is also working for promoting of renewable energy like biomass energy, solar energy and hydro energy. So they are been focusing mainly on solar energy. Solar energy the key area of is working. And TERI also conduct some programs like diploma, BTech, PhD program. Then second one is Sardar Swarn Singh National Institute of Bioenergy. So this institute work in bioenergy, like biomass energy. And again, conduct seminar, conference, and provide some BTech program, MTech program, and certificate course also. Again, this is related to TERI. So again, TERI conduct runs some programs, BTech program, MTech program, and PhD program also. So if anyone is interested, they can refer to this website and get admission for higher study also. So they are running MTech program also. Then nodal agency for Jharkhand is JEREDA, Jharkhand Renewable Energy Development Agency. So the key working area is biomass energy, wind power energy and solar energy. They are working in Jharkhand. This is a very important agency for Jharkhand. For the main aim is promotion of energy. So this is the working domain like micro solar, cold storage, solar tree, then solar thermal power. These programs are running under JEREDA. So these are the website. So in more detail you can refer to JEREDA. What they are, which programs are conducting, what their activity, you can refer this site. And what are the subsidy on different projects, so you can opt this site for detailed information. So again, JEREDA website, JEREDA. So they are running many programs like distribution of solar lantern, then street lighting, home lighting system, and they are providing some subsidy also for this type of gadgets. So these are all about the basic introduction of renewable energy. And in subsequent class, we will discuss basic of heat energy. What are the important terminology which will be utilized in solar energy? Okay.